as a kind of mediation between the state of sleeping and the state of writing. And I said, well, the same route. This is the whole point, to do exactly the same route every day, so I don't even have to think about it. Roll out of bed, and this small section of Hackney, which takes me through the most urban bit, the London Fields, which is where it was a drover's patch into Victoria Park, the Green Line to the Poor, back along the canal bank, which is hugely disputed now with pelotons of cyclists. The other cyber world, the electronic world. I think the important thing is not to have any input, just to be
you cut yourself off
very quiet, you're just walking through it, and you, by doing the same thing, there's no novelty other than the small changes that happen day by day.
Right, well, that suits you, the two of you, and it suits you in the great writers to have this thing about, but what, if there is any, what is the sign together but what is the sign together, if any, with walking act to inspire writers or helps, not just writers, helps us think?
Well, I think, from personal experience, very simply, by doing this physically, I found that if I didn't do it, I would get a backache, all of those kind of things. I haven't actually seen a doctor in my life. So very simple. You're at the bottom of the food chain of walking. Everybody's interested in cycling. If I've seen Boris Johnson.
Sure, actually, yeah, no, everything says you must
cycle. To begin to walk, I had to navigate around a kind of a great bank of Barclays bikes. I wasn't prepared to leave my bike, but you can't exploit walking. Walking is absolutely the bottom of the food chain.
Exactly, Claire, what did you say?
Well, I can't give any scientific explanation, but I think ideas come to you when you walk. And I often walk with my husband, who's a writer too, and I'm